Today, I'm going to share 8 excellent locations to use transcription apps. My name is Emily. I am hard of hearing. I have hearing aids in both ears. My hearing loss is genetic, which means I was diagnosed at birth and fit with hearing aids right away. I created this channel as a support to people who are deaf and hard of hearing, and also give some pointers to their family members and friends as to how to help their deaf or hard of hearing family member. All right, I hope you stick around to the end of this video, because if you do, I'm gonna tell you why the hospital is not a good place to use a transcription app. I hope you stick around to the end to hear the why for that. Please take a chance to like this video and subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to be making more great videos like this one, and I don't want you to miss out. So if you haven't already heard about transcription apps, they are amazing. Basically, what you do is you just open the app and hit play or go. Some apps just open automatically, and as people speak, it will type out what they're saying. These apps are really great. They're not 100% accurate like we all wish they were, but they still are very helpful in certain situations. Some transcription apps work well with background noise, some don't. Ideally, transcription apps work the best when just one person is talking and there's not a lot of noise happening around. So here are 8 great places to use a transcription app. Number 1, in school. I totally use my transcription app in school. I definitely had some benefits of using the Disability Center at my college, and I really like that. But sometimes it was just easier to just hit play and transcribe the whole lecture rather than having to rely on a note taker, where someone would just take notes and I would just blindly have to remember what part of class they were referring to. I just found that the transcription app worked better for me. Now, I will say you may want to get permission from professors and teachers before using this app, because some universities and colleges have policies on recording in class due to the fact that the teachers' lectures are their property and the property at the college. So you want to make sure that you don't get in trouble with that. When you meet with your disability counselor for school, whether it's in elementary school, middle school, high school, or college, and you're working on your IEP and 504 plan, it would be good to integrate the transcription option. Now, whenever I would go to those disability education meetings, whatever they may be, I would always put more down than I thought I would need. Using a transcription app is a great one to add. The second place that you can use a transcription app is in church. According to the rumors, there is a rising amount of deaf and hard of hearing people not going to church. And I definitely think the reason for this could be because we can't hear and understand what's going on. There are always so many things going on. The preachers and pastors and bishops and people in the congregation speaking, and then you've got the music, and whoa, it just can be a lot. So whether you're in a sermon or a meeting or a Sunday school, turning on a transcription app when there's one speaker speaking is really beneficial. And it's really awesome for me personally to be able to turn on my app and feel like I'm involved in the conversation. I feel like I can contribute and learn with those around me effectively. Number 3, you can use a transcription app on a plane. So a plane, it's just so hard to hear on a plane, not only because you have the air pressure changing, but also because of the fans, the loud engines. If you turn on your transcription app, you can typically hear the pilot when they start talking, and also the flight attendants when they come by. Now, I will say that most transcription apps need some sort of Wi-Fi or data to function, so it may or may not work while you're in the air if you do not have a Wi-Fi connection. Number 4, the next great place is when you are video chatting or video conferencing people. This could be for work or for fun. Google Hangouts has an awesome captioning system. I've tried it, I've loved it, and I'm surprised, it's pretty accurate. So if you can video chat via Google Hangout, do that and use those captions. But if not, pull up a transcription app when you are, say, on FaceTime on your computer. I have a Mac, so I pull up FaceTime on my Mac, and then I can have my transcription app on my iPhone. If you're an Android user, I have heard that Microsoft Transcribe Live is absolutely amazing. Thank you so much to the YouTubers that recommended those to me. You know who you are. If you have any app recommendations for me, I want to hear in the comments below. I really like Ava and Otter AI. Those are the two I use most often. Number 5, you can use a transcription app whenever you're listening to a speech. Now, this could be at an awards dinner or, say, a TED Talk platform, at a stand-up comedy location in a cafe, and so many other places. Speeches is a very broad term for one person is speaking to a crowd. Just pull your phone out of your pocket, hit play on the transcription app, and you'll be able to hear what is going on. Number 6, again, in meetings. And I mean like in-person meetings, not video conferences, not speeches, but if you're at a round table, say for a business meeting, everyone around you should know that you're deaf or hard of hearing. I feel like there is that fine line of telling people. I tell people when I feel like I need to tell them, but I don't walk into a room and announce like, I am hard of hearing. I just let them know when I either don't hear them five times or I feel like it's pertinent to mention. But if you're in a business meeting or a meeting in general, you can just say, hey, I'm pulling out my phone. I'm just gonna pull out my transcription app because I wanna hear everything you're saying because that's important to me. And they'll be like, oh, cool. You don't even have to mention that you're deaf or hard of hearing. Just pull it out, explain that you're using it, that you're focused on the conversation, and you're there to contribute. And I am confident that they will respect that. Number 7, you can use a transcription app at a store. I know that this takes more time to be able to pull it out, but if you have your phone out and ready when you're going through checkout, which is really the only person that you talk to people in the store, unless you walk up to someone and ask them a question, but anytime you anticipate talking to someone in a store, just pull out your phone, ask your question, they'll say the response, you look down, see it really quick, and answer accordingly. Our brains are incredible and they can respond incredibly fast. So if you can anticipate when you'll need a transcription app in a store, you may find that it is very beneficial. Last but not least, an excellent place to use a transcription app is in the passenger seat of a car. Yes, in the passenger seat of a car. Notice I said when you're in the passenger seat, not when you're driving. Don't use your phone when you're driving. That is not smart. That is not safe to anyone around you. I'm a runner. I run a lot. I almost get hit like once a run because people are texting while they're driving. It's just so bad. So you can use a transcription app in the passenger seat of a car because like a plane, a car is just, you can have cars that block out sound, but not all cars do that. I have a tin can car, very light, just the sound carries through the car, but I can pull out my transcription app and typically in a car, one person is talking and you just pull it out and anticipate their speech, and as they do that, just glance down quickly if you didn't catch what they said, and there you go, you can hear. So I hope that that helps. I hope that these are some locations that you can use a transcription app that you have not thought of. Are there any other locations that I missed? If so, I wanna hear in the comments below. I cannot wait to hear your responses. People always have such good opinions, especially like when that one specific person, they know who they are, mentioned live transcribe. I really appreciated that and I value that. Because I am hard of hearing, I feel like I understand and can relate with my deaf and hard of hearing comrades, and we can help each other out. YouTube is a great platform to do that. There are lots of other platforms, but sharing in the comments below helps. All right, thanks so much for sticking around to the end of the video. The reason that a hospital is not a good place for a transcription app is because of the importance of the information that is being exchanged when you go to see your doctor or when you're in a medical environment. Title III of the American Disabilities Act mandates that healthcare providers and doctors provide interpreters for deaf and hard of hearing people or other people with disabilities. That expense is their responsibility to cover. So if they ask you, oh, can you bring a friend or a family member, whether they want to save costs or not, you just say, no, I need an interpreter. And according to the American Disabilities Act, Title III, it is your responsibility to cover that. Using friends and family members as medical interpreters is a problem for two reasons. It can lead to bias and confidentiality issues. They're just so involved in your life, they care about you. Whether you receive good or bad news at the doctor, it can be misinterpreted because of their emotional attachments to you, which like, that's so great, they love you, but it's good to have a non-biased and confidential interpreter. I hope that helps. So don't use a transcription app in the hospital or in a doctor's office, but use it anywhere else. I hope this helps. If you have any questions for me, please leave them in the comments below. I hope you like this video. If so, please hit the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I look forward to making more excellent content.